It's the final curtain call for Newlands Stadium in Cape Town. And if you've ever watched a rugby match there, then you're probably feeling very sentimental right now. But the old girl has been in dire need of an upgrade for years. And now that Western Province Rugby Football Union has found a new home, it's the end of the road for this beloved icon of South African rugby. This is a hallowed space for Western Province and South African rugby fans. You can feel the history in this place, the ghosts of so many rugby highlights from as far back as 1891, when the first ever Springbok Test Series was played here against the touring British team. 130 years of rugby at Newlands, and everyone has a cherished memory, a special hero or seminal game. But it's aging. The upkeep is prohibitively high and it's not up to international safety standards. Fan numbers and executive suites have dwindled, and Western Province Rugby Football Union, which owns the stadium, is in a financial crisis.
Negotiations have been going on with the city of Cape Town for the past 4 years, and this is to make Western Province Rugby Union the anchor tenant at Cape Town Stadium, and the city would then carry the costs for the upkeep and maintenance.
Although the diehards can't contemplate the idea of moving, Stormers head coach John Dobson says the team has practiced there in the last few weeks and he can see the upsides.
Physically, it's just a magnificent stadium. It doesn't feel too open, you know, you still feel like we would hear the people, and the facilities are incredible, and we're aware that the aftermatch and the pre-match and all that will be better there.
And former Springbok Jean de Villiers admits Newlands change rooms aren't up to scratch.
In terms of world standards, it's probably not ideal to have just two toilets in a team of 25 plus management and all of that to share pre-game. You know, it becomes quite tricky at times.
But he's still heartbroken about the move.
It is literally where I fell in love with rugby. You know, I played my 101st test match here and I was able to run out onto the field with my kids, with my family being here, my wife pregnant with our son. My parents used to have season tickets, and it was really everything that I loved all thrown together into
one day. All put together in this little box, right?
In this place.
Equally nostalgic, Hussein Abrams has been coming here since he was 10.
I was here my first test in 1958. South Africa and France score 3-3, a drop goal by Pierre Danos and a try by Boots Lochner in the corner. The Lions came here 1962, I think. Then Thornett Wallabies team came here.
Brayton Paulse's speed and tries are legendary.
There's one try that I scored against the Auckland Blues back in the day. It was a star-studded Auckland Blues side where, you know, they had the likes of Carlos Spencer, you know, Jonah Lomu, Tano, Manga, those kind of players.
Oh, yes.
And ultimately, there was a try that sort of won the game for us.
So many legends. Mornay Duplessis, Skalk Berger, Chester Williams, Bobby Skinstad, Brian Habana, Ajo de Villiers, Percy Montgomery. The list goes on, and groundsman Mervyn Gabon has looked after most of them.
Come on, man, come on!
As groundsman for the past 33 years, he's witnessed rugby transform firsthand, encouraging young black players like Siya Kolisi, who calls him Papa, to push hard.
What is it like for you seeing him lifting that World Cup?
Whoa, it was vreugd. It was iets groot voor mij geweest. Even wat er om opgenoemd werd voor die kaptein, was ook iets groot.
Newlands is all about the people, from the groundsman to the coach. Traditions pass from one generation to the next. John Dobson's father, Paul, never missed a game from 1949, involved in all aspects of refereeing for over 60 years. He was your man if you wanted to know anything about Newlands. Sadly, he died of COVID in March.
Coach, I also firstly want to send out condolences. We're hoping that you're going to have had this conversation with him before you, right?
Yeah, he would be much better to speak about it than me. But yeah. Thanks for you. I appreciate that.
From 1949, he was here. And I'm sure at some stage, he was holding your hand as well.
The British Irish Lions of 1974 was the first time I came here. I was a ball boy once when I was 12. And I took Nas Boer to sand, you know, in a bucket. He was playing against the British Lions in 1980. And I gave him the sand and he even said thank you.
But Newlands, like South Africa, had its dark days. Hussein stayed away from Newlands from 1962, only returning in 1995. No normal sport in an abnormal society.
When I got to high school, I realized that there was nowhere I was going to sit in a segregated stand. This was, by the way, called the Malay stand.
Okay.
Students could never allow to sit on the field. That was reserved for the boys on the leafy suburbs. But for us, we had to be behind the fence.
Winning the World Cup in 1995 was the turning point in rugby that united the nation.
When you run out in a tunnel and people are going bonkers, you know.
When you hear that,
kind of thing, I've never experienced such wonderful fans. The little sayings that they have and just shouting for their team no matter what. Some of them can barely buy a ticket sometimes.
We had four or five guys that used to come. I think they were given tickets eventually by the union. And their job was just to chirp every single opposing player that comes onto this field.
Even in the bad old days, what happens outside New Orleans is different. But inside New Orleans, I mean, they were one homogeneous supporter group.
Often called the 16th player, the legendary New Orleans roar would carry Western Province over the line. Sadly, fans have dwindled and nostalgia isn't enough to save Newlands from the wrecking ball.
Newlands sits on some of the most commercially valuable real estate, but exactly how it is to be redeveloped still remains under wraps. It will have to be rezoned by the city of Cape Town, but the talk is it might be a mix of residential and commercial properties.
But the deals keep stalling. The amateur clubs control the professional body, and the rescue deals the professional board negotiates keep getting overruled. As things stand, nobody knows if this really is the last curtain for Newlands.
Western Province Rugby is asset rich but cash poor, and they've been in financial trouble for a number of years with deals coming on and off the table. So we asked the union president, Zelt Murray, for an interview, but he declined, saying that things were still in the process. Is the move definitely happening for 2021, you know, and does that mean all games will then be played there and this old lady goes to bed?
Yeah, you'd have to ask people several levels above my pay grade. We're hearing talk, maybe not, but the plan is we're going to Greenpoint next year.
There have been five resignations from the professional board this year alone. And veteran sports journalist Rob Howing says the boardroom battles and financial instability is crippling.
There's been a really unacceptable level of instability in the last couple of years, you know, where players haven't been sure where their next payday is going to be coming from. I don't know how many Springboks they'll have left on their books the way things are going.
It's been, I mean, three deals in 3 years. It was the Remgro Group, then it was Investec, and now the Flight Group. But it still seems there's no money in the bag and there's no momentum.
There's been a little bit of an ideological shift at Newlands as well. Yes. You know, a reflection of the sort of the changing times, the changing demographics in South Africa. The people who now wield the power have been wanting, rightly or wrongly, to sort of shift away from what might be called the sort of the old money, and whether sort of doing a U-turn and seeking other equity possibilities from corporations that don't have a massive sort of long-standing reputation. There are risks involved.
The rugby fraternity is now impatient for answers.
I never really thought in my wildest dreams when we were playing rugby that Newlands one day won't be no more.
COVID has already silenced the legendary Newlands roar, but they're hoping they can lift the eerie silence just once more.
What for you would be that ideal send-off for your boys, for your team, and, you know, in memory also for people like your dad?
Sia Khaleesi lifting the Curry Cup in front of a full Newlands on the 23rd of January. I could think of nothing more beautiful to say, for lots of levels, to say goodbye to the place.
Thank you for watching our stories here online, and please subscribe below to become part of our YouTube community and be notified when we upload our latest content.